So now I'm going to talk about magnetic vector potential. In electrostatics, we have already identified a convenient relationship between electric scalar potential, V, and electric field strength, E. Okay, so because of the scalar component of the electric potential, we are able to simplify some of the ways to define or to get the electric field strength. We use this knowledge to, number one, relate electric field distributions in resistors and capacitors to the voltages across them. So we can find the correlation between the voltage across a resistor and capacitor to its electric field distribution. And number two, we have already used this knowledge to find one via the other. That means we can use electric scalar potential to find the electric field intensity. Okay, so now, because of this, we would like to find an equivalent relationship for the magnetic flux density. So we need to look back for electrostatics and magnetostatics. For electrostatics, we have this equation here, which states the relationship E equals to negative gradient of the electric scalar potential. E equals to negative del V. Okay, so there are some mathematical derivations involved for us to get what is known as the Poisson's equation, that find the relationship between the electric scalar potential V and the volume charge density in an electric field. Right? And furthermore, we can extend the relationship in integral form to find the relationship. That means by using these equations, if you are given the volume charge density, you can find the electric scalar potential for that distribution and vice versa. So we want to look at magnetostatics, whether we can achieve the same thing. Now, there are actually some mathematical derivations involved, but for this subtopic, I am just going to focus on the equation itself. So you are welcome to study on your own how it is derived. Okay, sources are available from textbook or online. But the thing I want to highlight is the equation. First is this equation. So when we talk about magnetic vector potential, so since we cannot have a magnetic scalar potential because it always has a direction. So that's why we have to represent it as a magnetic vector potential. So the relationship given through some derivation is B equals to del cross A. A here is the magnetic vector potential. Okay, so if you are given the vector magnetic potential, you can apply curl to it to get the magnetic flux density B. Okay, so the equivalent to Poisson's equation is this equation here. It defines the relationship between the magnetic vector potential with the charge current density. Okay, with the current density J. So there are some derivations that I skip because I want to focus on the relationship only. And finally, the last equation is how the magnetic vector potential A relates to current density in integral form. And you can find it using this equation here. Okay, so that's it about magnetic vector potential. So the rest is just application of the equation in order to solve the problems that we need to.